everyone. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. Opening week in the NFL is an exciting time for everybody, including these two teams here today. It's the Giants going up against the Cowboys. The opening kick of the new season is straight ahead as we turn it over to our broadcast duo of Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Larry, thank you very much. We are pleased, as always, to be bringing you coverage of the National Football League presented by EA Sports. Obviously, they do everything big here in Dallas, and the introduction to the Cowboys, no exception. They're set for football in Big D, as their guys will do battle with the New York Giants. Welcome in, everyone. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden, and partner, training camp over, preseason over. It's time for week one.
And how much fun is that? No longer do we have to talk about who's going to make the team. The rosters are set. These guys now get to go out and play for real. No more of these preseason games. Now they're playing, and the records count.
And he'll take this across the 25, a couple extra yards, up to the 27-yard line. So here are the Cowboys now ready to go on offense for the first time. Their second-year QB leading them, it's the NFL's Offensive Rookie of the Year for 2017, Dak Prescott.
For a fourth-round selection, Dak Prescott looked as comfortable as a rookie quarterback could look right from game one. And by the end of the year, accumulated a lot of statistics, but the biggest one, 13 wins, which tied him with Ben Roethlisberger for the most as a rookie starting quarterback.
Now the first carry for Ezekiel Elliott. And they'll bring him down after just a short pickup. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8. The offensive starters now for the Cowboys.
The trademark of the Cowboys offense is balance. They start with the running game, the number 2 running team in the NFL in 2016. And while the number 23 passing number may give some cause for alarm, don't look at it that way. They run the ball so well and so effectively that when they do decide to throw the football, it often results in big plays downfield.
Second down, Prescott. Out to the flat, that's complete to his running back. And the defense for New York.
I still remember when Dominique Rodgers-Cromartie came out of Tennessee State in the draft, and I called a coach in his conference to ask a scouting report about him, and he said, well, we didn't do anything special. We didn't throw away from him or anything like that. I don't think that coach told me the truth. DRC is one of the best ball hawks in the league, had 6 interceptions in 2016, and continues to lock down elite receivers.
An early tough test on the opening drive. This is 3rd and 8. From the shotgun, it's Prescott. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he's going to have the first down at about the 38. It's a 10-yard pickup, and it moves the chains. The numbers for Dak as a rookie last year are still kind of mind-boggling. When you look at QB rating, Dak was 104.9. Now, among full-time quarterbacks, only 2 Super Bowl quarterbacks, Matt Ryan and Tom Brady, were higher.
And look who we finished ahead of. Guys like Aaron Rodgers, Drew Brees, Russell Wilson, amazing.
First down carry by Elliott. And that one goes for about 6 as he's taken down just shy of the 45. Elliott last year is so darn good, over 1,600 yards, most in the NFL. Actually, there were 10 teams that didn't rush for as many yards as he did. That's how good he was.
And just think, there is a place for him to get better. And I think it's in pass receiving, not necessarily the hands, but just throwing it to him more, getting him into open space. He can make even more big plays doing that.
5 yards on the play there as the drive will continue.
Boy, he does it at a high level, doesn't he? Because when I watch him, I think of his vision. Straight ahead, peripheral. Also has that sense of where holes are going to be before they actually open. I think that helps set him apart from many of the other backs in the league.
So the run gets them the first, and now they operate with a fresh set of downs. Here's Prescott. And It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And he'll take it down shy of the 45 at the 46. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down.
Well, the strategy was evident there. Get it to your tight end and make it a one-on-one play with a cornerback. Who's usually going to win that one?
The tight end, but not there.
Not in this situation. How about the corner defeating that logic and making a really nice tackle?
A second down throw for Prescott. Looking for his running back, and he's got him. And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. It'll go as a gain of 6 that time, and it moves the chains as well. How about the start throwing the football? 4 for 4 on this opening drive.
Oh, he's slinging it. And oftentimes when you talk about slinging it, you're thinking about a guy throwing it all over the yard, not necessarily accurately. In this case, though, he's honing in on his targets, and he's delivering.
Yeah, the opening script, however they drew it up for this first drive, going to plan so far. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's 2nd and 9.
Nice job by that defensive front there to hold him to a short gain on first down. Well played, I must say.
Yeah, only getting 1 yard. There was no room to run. And the 8th play on this drive coming up. Prescott now on 2nd down. And on the left side, he's got Witten. And he's going to get it down to the 33-yard line here. The reception good for 7. It's 3rd down.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
Prescott on 3rd and 2. Complete to Jason Witten. And he's going to have the first down yardage as he's down at about the 30-yard line. Dak finding his tight end Witten, and the Cowboys have a first down. And the seemingly endless drive continues. Now back to the ground with Elliott. And he will lose yardage here to the 31-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be 2nd down.
Wow, that play got shut down in a hurry.
As soon as the snap came, you can see defensively they were just closing in. That was going nowhere.
Yeah, you count on your offensive line to give you a little bit of space, a little bit of time so you can make a move. There was none there for him.
Looking to throw, Prescott. They'll set up the screen to Elliott. And he'll lose yardage. Brought down at the 32. It's a loss of 2, now 3rd down.
Time to give a little credit here. That was an excellent read by the guys on the defensive side of the ball.
Oh, you're crediting your defense.
Gotta credit them on that one because they tried to fool them, right? Tried to trick them, ran a screen, and they went to it and smothered it for a loss of yardage.
So 1 quarter in the books here on our first Sunday night telecast of the year. Nothing, nothing, our score. EA Sports NFL Sunday returns following this.
The NFL on EA Sports is presented by Snickers. You're not you when you're hungry. Snickers satisfies.
Sitting alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden as it is Cowboy football to begin quarter number 2. They're in the midst of a nice drive, but facing a 3rd and long here. Ooh, long drive. The defense just cannot seem to catch a break and get off the field. On 3rd down, it's Prescott. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
Pressure, and that's certainly going to be a key to this game going forward. And that time, they were able to get in there and influence the throw. And remember, quarterbacks got to get rid of it. They don't have the tucker rule that they can fall back on anymore.
And it is good. Well, that one looked to be in trouble the whole way, but it does get over the bar. And the Cowboys are going to jump out to a 3-0 lead. So they get the field goal, but partner, that was a 14-play drive to get the 3.
Normally, when you hold the ball that long, run that many plays, you end up in the end zone. There's a breakdown on the defense. Something happens. In this case, that didn't, but really good ball control by the offense. They're hoping that they can wear them down if they keep having drives like that.
Let's field it a few yards into the end zone. So here are the Giants ready to start their initial drive of the game. They'll be led out by the veteran quarterback, a multiple-time Pro Bowler. It's, of course, Eli Manning.
Eli getting the start here in week one, and that means his consecutive start streak is now up to 200. His brother got to 208, so right about midseason, he could be breaking that mark, but still has to try and chase down Brett Favre, who finished with 297 consecutive starts.
Now a first carry here for Shane Vereen. And he's not going anywhere to start the night. They stop him at the line of scrimmage. They stick on the ground. Again, it's Vereen. And he'll get this one up to the 26. 1 yard, the official pickup there, so it's going to set up third and nine.
The best defensive linemen, they play with great leverage so they can get low and not get bowled over by offensive linemen. They have excellent hands. They can throw people off on a play. We just saw.
And the Cowboys' pressure gets there this time for the sack. Sean Lee in there to drop him for a 6 yard loss, and that'll lead to a fourth down.
Well, that play was the very definition of fast, quick, and in a hurry. Suddenly, he was there.
In a blink of an eye, that happened fast and a big sack. The fourth-year man from LSU, Brad Wing, to punt it away. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. It's taken to the 26. It'll be a 51-yard punt that time. And the Cowboys will take over the football with a first and 10. The Cowboys offense heading back out and ready to go again. And they split the uprights last time for three. They've got the lead. They're not going to play this conservative. They're not hoping for another field goal. They're hoping for a touchdown.
I'm with you on that one. I like where your head is. I like the way you're thinking because you're exactly right. Trying to sit on a lead and play that way, that doesn't work too well for most teams. Run your offense. Run what you do best. Exactly. Put it all the way down and try to increase your lead in a big way. And the best way to do it, touchdowns.
Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and nine.
Well, he hasn't made much of an impact in the running game thus far, and after that last run, not much is going to change in that area.
He hasn't been able to get anything going, and really the offensive line not helping him much. Throwing, Prescott. Trying to get it to Williams, but it's intercepted. Picked off by Landon Collins. And a terrific return there. They're finally able to corral him down near the 11-yard line.
And Brandon, this is a real nice job defensively of getting inside a quarterback's head and figuring out, okay, where's he going with the football? Because you can make an educated guess defensively, not all the time, but sometimes. And when you're right, you've got a decent chance of coming away with the football.
Here comes the Giants offense back out onto the field. They were forced to punt last time. Now, I doubt sincerely that they'll have to punt here because they're gifted with terrific field position.
I don't even want to think about the idea that they would end up punting starting with this type of field position. Neither do they. Great starting spot, great opportunity to run your full playbook. They want to take a shot here, they can go ahead and do it.
So after the INT, it's Manning. Trying to lob it in there, but it's incomplete. He was trying to hit his big receiver, Brandon Marshall, and that'll bring up second down.
This defense is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. He came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in. Go!
Offense still needing 10 yards. Second down. They'll run here with Vereen. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. It'll be a pickup of five, and that leaves him with five more. Third and five now.
That second down play call was not to pick up the first down. It was to accomplish what they did to get him into a manageable third down because they had the incompletion on first down, so they were behind the sticks, so to speak. They needed to make up some ground, and they did.
Throwing now is Manning. And that is caught. He's got it for a giant touchdown. Brandon Marshall, his first touchdown in a Giant uniform. And the Giants are in for six. So a tiptoe catch back of the end zone, so tough to do, but he made it look pretty easy.
Certainly did, and the back of the end zone is treated the same way as the sideline. You have to get your feet down in bounds for it to count as a catch. How about the backgrounds of some of these guys, though? Did they work on it? Maybe some of them were ballet, some dance, who knows?
Yeah, you and I were talking the other day. I remember one of my favorite kid shows growing up. I don't know that I want to name it, but guys like Lynn Swan, they used to be on there showing their ballet skill.
And you have to remember when they were kids and their parents were telling them to take the ballet classes, you know they were fighting them like crazy. But right now they're saying, thanks, Mom.
Aldrich Rosas on for the extra point. Now this is up and good to make it 7-3. Scoring summary, three-play drive, and it was polished off by a Giants touchdown. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. This is taken at his four, and his guys will get the football right at the 20-yard line. Here comes the field general leading his offense back out there for the next possession. He's likely still kicking himself from the interception last drive that wound up leading to a go-ahead score.
And he's going to assume all that came with that one, all right? That's all on him, but he also knows he's got to erase it from his mind and get back out there. This drive, very important.
And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
The one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown him a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after him. They've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept him on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. A second down throw for Prescott. And this is caught by Witten, the tight end. And they'll bring him down here up at about the 22-yard line. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down.
I think it's okay there. They didn't get a whole lot on that play, but it's nice to have a safety valve that's built like this guy. Big target, guy you can spot pretty easily. Put it on him when your other targets aren't open.
Prescott from the gun on third. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
And you just know when that play call came in, their eyes lit up because anytime you get a chance to take a big shot downfield, that's a lot of fun, and they missed an opportunity.
Now the seventh-year man Chris Jones on to kick. Back deep, it's Odell Beckham. Here's Beckham. That's going to go in the books as a 55-yard punt. Well done. And it'll be Giant football first and 10. Now out come the Giants. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
First down, here's a handoff to Green. And they take him down, losing yardage back at the 27. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down. 2 minutes to play here in the first half. We're back to Arlington right after this timeout.
Yeah.
A reminder coming up at this and every halftime this season, we'll be checking in with Larry Ridley in Orlando for highlights and analysis of our first half.
LR, that's my man.
That's your guy. And that is, I think he caught it. He did, but they'll say out of bounds. It'll be incomplete. They were trying to get it there to Sterling Shepard. Third down here.
Oh, he caught it. Just couldn't get the feet down. Couldn't get that toe tap sequence, right? I was ready to call him tippy toes if that one was completed.
On the run, here's Vereen. And he maybe makes it back to the line of scrimmage. That's it. And now a timeout called by the Cowboys defense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. Here's Brad Wing now. On for his second punt. He'd take a repeat of his first. He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. This is taken at about the 14. So dangerous with a football in his hands. Call that a return of 38. And this offense takes over in great shape right at the 50, first and 10. Come the Cowboys. And on the last go around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means they're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. Here's Prescott. And this one's incomplete.
Let's face it, you can run the route tree as many times as you want, get in sync, practice it, do all those things. But once you get to game speed, it doesn't always time up quite that well. That one goes incomplete.
Throwing again, Prescott on second and 10. Pressure, and he's gonna be taken down. They sack him back right around the 44. Jason Pierre-Paul in there to drop him, and it'll be a loss of about 8. Third and long for Prescott. And he can't hang on to it. Nearly picked. He's known for his hands defensively. But instead, it just brings up fourth down. Well, they've had a pretty frustrating first half here offensively, and then just continued there with that incompletion.
Yeah, definitely frustrating for them, but heartening for the other guys. Those stop troops, they're enjoying things right now because they've made it very difficult for them throughout the half.
And a great job here. This is going to turn out to be a beauty. This is marked down at about the 3-yard line. Odell Beckham now marching back onto the field. Not only does he not have a catch, I don't think he's been targeted in this game, but they're winning.
And if you ask a receiver of his magnitude, he'll tell you that it's because everyone is focused on him anyway. Okay, you've taken it away. No catches, no targets, but we're still winning. I've opened things up for the rest of my team. I know how receivers think.
They've been using him as a decoy, and effectively so. And not much there as he gets it up to about the 5-yard line. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down. Now before the second down play, we'll get whistles and a timeout, as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. Manning the throw on second down. He gets this one to Dwayne Harris. Now the Giants will use the second of their 3 timeouts, as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. Manning. And he's going to be brought down. Back at his own 6-yard line. Tyrone Crawford in there to drop him, and it'll be a loss of about 8. And we say it all the time, have to be able to get rid of the ball sooner than that.
you have to help your offensive line out. They're going to protect you as best they can. And if you're getting 3 to 5 seconds to throw the ball, they're doing a really nice job. But when you hold it and give up a sack, you're really almost discrediting their work.
No gain on the play this time, and it'll be a third and long situation coming up. So we've reached halftime here in our initial Sunday night telecast of the new season. As we send you on over to Orlando, where we'll check in with Larry Ridley. He's got our EA Sports halftime report. Larry?
All right, let's roll those moving pictures. Cowboys now on 3rd and 8. Prescott's on point with the throw, and he'll eventually be brought down, but not before getting to their own 38-yard line. Cowboys will settle for 3 points on the drive. Cowboys take it early in the second. Prescott's under fire and will throw the pick. Collins, reading the play, comes away with it, ending the drive. Offense out now following the interception. It's Manning finding the machine, Brandon Marshall. And this play goes for a score. The lead grows to 4. That'll do it for here in Orlando. Let's get you back out to Dallas as we hand things over to Brandon Guy.
So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number 3. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he won't return this one. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start at the 25. And the Giants ready to come out now. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters, as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had the ability to see what you've done. They're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace, because you are looking for some separation in this ballgame.
The adjustment to the adjustment.
Without a doubt. Show them one thing, hit them with something else. Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it.
And he will go down, a Cowboys sack. DeMarcus Lawrence in there to bring him down for a loss of 7. He didn't get rid of the football there, took the sack. Although that's easier said than done. He can't just chuck the thing sideways into the seats.
No, he really can't, because you're not afforded total protection as a quarterback. You have to get outside of the tackle boxes as defined by the NFL, meaning wherever your tackles operate normally, get outside of that. And the ball that you throw has to get back to at least the line of scrimmage. Otherwise, you face an intentional grounding call.
A pretty good coverage there, and both of these defenses, they've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it, and in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides, where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
We'll call that a punt of 54 yards. Well struck. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. The Giants' defense now ready as they trot back out onto the field. They have a little something to build off of from last time with a 3-and-out.
And what they have to build off of? Great confidence right now. Being able to stuff someone on a 3-and-out, you feel like you're in control now. You're doing the dictating. They want to see if that can continue as this game progresses.
Will it continue? We'll see. Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it 2nd down.
I'd say they've got to find a way to get him going. He's such a big part of their offense. I wonder if they might throw it a little and come back to the run.
Anything, because you're right, he's pretty much been completely neutralized. 2nd down following the run. Prescott down. Blitz coming, and down he goes. Jason Pierre-Paul in there to get him for his 2nd sack of the night.
That's his 2nd sack of the game, and the best defensive ends, they do their homework as much as offensive guys do. They know how to beat the offensive lineman across from them, what moves they need to do to set them up. This guy's been pretty good at it all game long.
They'll need a big play here. Will Dak and the Cowboys after the sack. It's 3rd and long. Prescott from the gun. He completes it to Bryant. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this into enemy territory across the 40. A very solid gain of 27. So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. They'll run with Elliott, fighting his way down to about the 35-yard line. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Well, they're hoping that the second half is better for him than the first half. They've got to find a way to get him going. He's a big part of their offense.
And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. Prescott. And he rifles one incomplete.
I know our vantage point might be a little bit better way up here, but that looked like an ill-advised throw to me. I didn't see anything open, and this play just didn't look right from the beginning.
It did not. I thought he might get outside and just chuck it away. Dangerous pass, incomplete. The Cowboys on third down. They've hit it 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. This is third and 7. Out of the gun. Here's Prescott. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete. So he can't hang on, and as I watch that unfold, I remembered an expression that I've heard, maybe from you, I don't know, but you're going to get hit anyways, might as well hold on to the ball.
Right, you know a coach said that, right?
Yeah.
Not an actual player.
No. Oh, they get to the football. It's blocked. Now it's a foot race. He's at the 40, the 20. 10, and he will score. Touchdown, Giants. We talk about it a lot. One of the dangers of the long field goal, you got to kind of hit it low and drive it. That makes it susceptible to a block here. Not only do they block it, they return it.
And how about how well they did on the return, where they didn't create a penalty? Oftentimes in that type of a scrambling situation, someone will clip, someone will block below the waist, right? You name it. In this case, though, that didn't happen. They formed it up, and he took it all the way back for a touchdown.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. Here comes Ryan Switzer to return it. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. So out come the Cowboys now as their offense gets set to take over. Down throw for Prescott. It's caught by Bryant, and he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. A gain of 6 there on first. Great change up there on the route and got that inside release, made it a successful pitch and catch.
Well, the first thing you want to do is have him thinking that you're going outside, make a move in that direction. Then you really don't run the route against the whole body of the defender. You run against a half of him and the inside half, and he took it right across his face, got inside, and won that route in a big way.
Here's Elliott. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. First down, Prescott. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
That would have been a great catch, but it was real difficult to hold on to it because it was contested all the way. Would have been a great play if he'd been able to haul that one in.
Second down, Prescott again. He's got a man wide open, complete. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 20-yard line. 23 yards on the play.
And there's another completion to the tight end. And let's face it, it is hard to overthrow a 6 foot, 6 inch target.
It is indeed. Quarterbacks like their speed guys. They like that huge 6'6" target that they've got in him.
They really do. And it reminds me of what one great tight end told me once. He told his quarterback, just make sure you throw it up there. You know, kind of like put it up on the top shelf where the kids can't get it.
10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. To the air again, Prescott. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Devon Kennard coming on the blitz. He gets him for a loss of 7. Now Prescott. And he fires one, but incomplete.
Just looking at it from a defensive perspective, when you break the huddle in the red zone, tight end is one of the guys you've got a key on, because quarterbacks want the ball in their hands fast in this position, and they want to get it to someone. And in this case, he had the play. They just didn't complete it.
And Bailey able to knock it through. And that will finish off this third quarter of play. One quarter remains here on a Sunday night. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. For the fourth quarter, we'll begin with a kickoff following the score on the final play of the third quarter. Bailey now to kick this one away. That's fielded in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. And now back onto the field. Here comes the Cowboys defense. They got the stop last time that resulted in a punt, and then it resulted in 3 for their offense.
And this is one time where the defense won't get credit for creating points, but that's exactly what they did. All right, forced them into a punt, turned it over to their offense. Guess what? Points went on the board.
Points went on the board, 3 of them. Now they'll be looking for another stop. No gain on the play there, 2nd down. He has just been completely taken out of this game. We're in the fourth quarter. He's single digits in the rushing department.
And I know we look at him because the numbers do go to his production, but how about the guys blocking for him? They don't just have his number as a ball carrier. They've got the number of the offensive line.
And the ball is knocked out. It's picked up by the Cowboys. And they take possession of the football and have it at the 36-yard line.
Well, partner, here's where team football gets tested a little bit, because I know the defensive guys were over there chilling on the sidelines, and all of a sudden, they heard the sudden change call, because that fumble puts them right back on the field. And they've got to go out and finish the game now themselves.
Absolutely. Nursing that slim lead here in the fourth, a costly turnover. The offense for the Cowboys now working their way back onto the field. And last time able to get 3. It's not what they wanted. They wanted 6, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the drive.
They'll take it. Just I like the way you've described it. Not ideal, but they'll take it. Anything to put some points on the board. But this time on offense, they don't even want to see the field goal kicker trot on the field. They want that ball in the end zone.
Yeah, they'll be going for 6. 10th carry now for Elliott. And able to push his way forward here for a good little game. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up 2nd down. Tough running there. That's a hard-earned 4 yards.
Yeah, those are the unsung kind of runs. They don't fill up the stat sheet, but they do set you up in good position on 2nd down.
See if they stay on the ground for 2nd down. To throw is Prescott. Completes it to Jason Witten. And he'll be a little shy of the 25 here at the 26-yard line. It's a pickup of 6 and good enough to move the chains. 5th catch of the game for him there.
Yeah, and the tight end position is now becoming a volume pass catcher. Used to be occasional, right, safety valve. Throw one to him every so often, but mainly they want him out there to block. Nowadays, an integral part of the passing game, and they create such great mismatches that they often become the leading receiver.
Officially, no gain on the play, and it's 2nd down. And this defense continues to give them fits. They just can't get really anything going on the ground, can they?
I love the theme that you just brought up. This defense has been tough all game long against the run. We just saw another example of it there.
Under four to go now as the clock runs and they come up on second down. Second down, Prescott. Drops it underneath, Dalian. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. A really nice pickup of 14 yards, and it moves the sticks.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage look defensively. First and 10, Prescott. This will be caught just inside the 10. And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Seeing that play and understanding just how tough it is to cover tight ends, especially the ones running around the NFL nowadays, makes me glad I didn't make it in that league. I would have had a really difficult time.
But now you get to sit up here with me.
Yeah, and that's fun, isn't it? And what a really nice game right there on first down for them. Brings up a nice second down for them.
The quick slant caught. And he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the 1-yard line. They give him 2 yards there as they're set up now with a first and goal.
Many different ways to create space, but on that play, he did it with that big, wide body of his. Didn't get a whole lot of yardage on the play, but it did what it was supposed to, pick up a first down.
And it looks like this will be the last play before the 2-minute warning. They'll try to run it in with Elliott. And no signal yet. I don't think he got in. He didn't. They'll mark him at the 1. So the Cowboys in possession of the football here as we get you reset. They come up on a second down now in a game that looks like it's going to go down to the wire. They come out here in the eye. And they'll let the fullback try and take him home. And he is not going to get in as the big bodies stop him at the 1. They're held again, and do we have a goal line stand brewing? It's 3rd and goal. The offense on 3rd down, they've converted 3 times and 8 chances. They're looking at a 3rd and goal here. Is going to be incomplete. This defense has watched their lead dwindle away. This is where they really need to bow up. They executed well there.
And it's often hard after you've played really well early and then you kind of relax a little bit to step on the gas again. They just did it on the last play. Looks like they want to finish this one off.
Likely the play of the game here, trailing in the final quarter and going for it on 4th and goal. Running with Elliott, and he'll get in. Touchdown, Cowboys. Ezekiel Elliott taking it in from a yard out. And now the Cowboys are within a 2-point conversion of tying up the game.
The touchdown is huge, but the focus now is on the 2-point play. I don't want to say they have a cushion here, but if they don't get it, they still have a chance for onside kick.
They would need some big-time help, but you're right. There would be a shot, but the focus right now on that 2-point conversion. All right, so the Cowboys will go for 2 here. He'll look to throw, and it's caught. And with it, we are tied here in the 4th. huge, huge conversion there to tie this thing up, but they're not done yet. Their defense needs to get a stop.
Yeah, there's still plenty of time for the other team to come downfield and put some points on the board. But job one was taken care of, the two-point conversion to get this thing tied.
So here comes the kickoff now, all even here in this fourth quarter. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. And New York set to take the field. They've got work to do, but they do still have a bit of time here.
And they've got to feel comfortable with that, but they have all their play sequences called. They get out of bounds, that allows them to huddle and call another play. But if they don't, it's hurry up to the line of scrimmage and either spike it and stop the clock or continue to move it downfield in order to try and get in range and win this game.
See if they can do just that. Manning gonna throw. Harris has it over the middle. And they're able to get this one across the 35. They give them 14 yards that time and a fresh set of downs. Manning to throw. And he's got his rookie first rounder. It's Evan Engram. And he's going to be out of bounds right at midfield. That one goes for 13 yards and it moves the sticks.
We always hear from coaches how much they like to run crossing routes because they want to hit their receivers on the go, get them the ball, and keep them moving. How about when you hit a tight end that way? Okay, the receivers are going to run past you most of the time. The tight end, they can do their damage a different way, break a few tackles, and really scatter some people, can't they?
A gain of six there on first. To throw, it's Manning. It's hauled in by Shepard. And he'll get it down on the play to the 37. It goes as a gain of eight, and it moves the chains. They're making steady progress, but I see your face. You're worried about that clock.
I'm worried about the clock, and at some point, you have to have a splash play in there as well.
Offense comes to the line now, first and 10. They'll run. It's Vereen. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. And before this second down play, we'll get a whistle, a signal, and a timeout. As the clock stops with 23 seconds to go in the game. They'll run again with Vereen. And he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line. Now the Giants will use the second of their three timeouts as they get it with just 19 seconds left on the clock. The Giants on third down. They've only converted once in four tries. This is third and 7. To throw is Manning. He's got Adams on the hookup. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 15. A good pickup there of 20 yards. Now here's a timeout as they will indeed call it with 5 seconds to go and a chance with a field goal to win the game. So it all comes down to a rookie kicker, Aldrick Rosas. And his kick is good. And it's celebration time on that sideline as they have taken the lead in the final seconds. So he comes through in a hostile environment, and you'd have to imagine that's the game winner.
Without a doubt. The way this one's gone, they didn't want to take any chances in overtime if they could help it. And that was one heck of a pressure-filled kick.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This one taken from the 7. Well, this one, partner, was fun down to the very end. They got the points late, right before the whistle. Then the ensuing kickoff. They were hoping for magic on the other side, but couldn't get that spark.
Fun if you won, and fun for us, because we got to watch it and call it. That magic that you were talking about didn't occur at the end, but what a game all the way through.
So for the Giants, it wasn't always pretty, but they do eke out the week one victory here by a field goal. And they'll return home next week to take on the Detroit Lions. Meanwhile, for the Cowboys, they obviously fall to 0-1 with the defeat. And they'll look to get back on track next week as they travel to Denver to take on the Broncos. So that'll just about do it for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gauden. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, log on to EASports.com. Good night, everybody.